Welcome you back once again in geological knowledge.
So as you know that we all are dealing with the some important questions, objective types of questions which are related to mineralogy. And in mineralogy basically we are dealing with the physical properties of minerals. And so far we have discussed about the hardness, the color, cleavage as well as the fractures. And luster we have also discussed. And in this current discussion, we will discuss some other very important questions which are related to the exam point of view, very important for the exam point of view. So let's start our discussion. And this focuses on the physical properties of minerals. So this is the fourth video in that succession. And if you have not seen the previous videos, I will provide the link in the description box. From there you can watch it out, because they are very important questions. So let's start our discussion. So first question deals with the property of mineral by virtue of which it can be cut with a knife is known as. Means, what is the property of a mineral by virtue of which it can be cut with a help of a knife? So what is that property known as? Parting, sectile, malleable, or the ductile? So the behavior of a particular mineral towards the forces that tend to break or bend, cut or crush is described by the term tenacity. Okay, so tenacity means the behavior of a particular rock towards the forces which tend to break or bend, cut or crush in some pieces. So that property of minerals, that is known as tenacity. Okay, so thus when a mineral can be cut with a knife, so that is known as sectile. Okay, so the correct option here is option B, sectile. Next one is mica is. So here the question is related with mica, that it's flexible or rigid or flexible and elastic, or it's elastic. Okay, so these are some properties. Like some minerals are sometimes flexible in nature, some are rigid in nature, and some are flexible as well as elastic, and some are only elastic in nature. Okay, so these are some fundamental qualities or the properties of minerals. And this question deals with the mica only. So we know that is there are several varieties of mica, and some minerals are not only flexible but they are elastic also. So this is the, that is, they regain their shape when the forces applied on them, they are removed. Okay, so that is the property of elasticity. When we apply force on some object or some mineral, so they get compressed or the tensile in stress, but whenever we remove that force, so they again get their shape. So that's why this property is known as elasticity. And flexibility is also the property of mica. So mica are the best examples, hence they are both flexible as well as elastic. Okay, so the correct option here is option C, flexible as well as elastic in nature. Next one is when the mineral these occurs in flattened or the square form, they are known as. When the minerals they occur in flattened or the elongated form or square form, they are known as tabular, voidoidal, elongated, or the box. So we all know that is the some minerals which show broad flat surfaces in the orientation of the mineral, so they are known as tabular structures. Okay, and the best example is feldspar. So the mineral that occurs in the form of a flattened square or the rectangular, or in some cases it can be rhombohedral also, say if it is said to be, then it's said to be tabular form. And in other words, we can say flattening is a conspicuous compared to lengthwise elongation. okay? So they are flattened in a particular direction, and the example as we have talked about, that is the feldspar. Okay, so the right answer or the right correct option here is option A, tabular form. Next one is example of elongated structure is, example of elongated structure, calcite, beryl, orthoclase or the barite. So what are elongated structures? So when the particular mineral is in the form of a thin or the thick elongated columnar like structure, column crystals, this is said to be elongated in form. And the best example is beryl. Okay, the example of this is beryl, and sometimes they can also be known as the columnar structures. So minerals showing the columnar crystals, for example the tourmaline, that is also known as elongated form. Okay, so the option, correct option here is option B, beryl. Next one is kyanite shows which form, which form is shown by kyanite, columnar, elongated, bladed or the tabular form. So the mineral appears as if composed of a thin, flat or the bladed like overlapping or juxtaposed parts if it is said to be bladed in nature. Okay, so mineral showing the bladed habit, basically we are dealing with the habit. Okay, so firstly we will understand what is habit. So habit of a mineral may be defined as the size as well as the shape of the crystal, means the shape and the size of the mineral in which form it relates to. So that property, that physical property of that mineral is known as habit. And the structures or the form shown by the crystals aggregates and the crystalline masses. Okay, and there are certain types of habits, and we are talking with them like acicular, fibrous, foliated, bladed, tabular, columnar, and sometimes botryoidal, reniform, granular, piezolytic, oolitic shape or the massive form. So these are very important and very well defined significant physical properties of the habit, means in which form they are occurring, whether they are rounded in shape or elongated in shape or radiating in the form or the bulbous structure. When they are bulbous means there is no shape, so then it's known as massive. Okay, or when the non-crystalline or the cryptocrystalline minerals, they occur as structureless, there is no structure, there is no orientation of the bonding or the molecules in the mineral, so that is known as massive form. Okay, so now we come back to our question, kyanite shows which form. So the mineral that appears as if composed of the thin, flat as well as the bladed like overlapping or the juxtaposition parts, then that property is known as bladed structure, or that structure is known as bladed, and the best example being kyanite. Okay, the correct option here is option C, bladed type. Next one is structure or the form which depicts leaf like seat is known as, structures or the form which depicts the leaf like seats is known as foliated, lamellar, radiating or the granular. So the lamellar is the correct option, and if we talk about the mineral is made up of relatively thick, flexible or the leaf like seeds, if it is said to be lamellar form. Okay, and the best example of these type of minerals, that is known as vermiculite. Okay, so vermiculite is a very important mineral which show the lamellar form. Okay, so the correct option here is option B. Next one is muscovite mica shows which structure, which structure is shown by muscovite mica, lamellar, foliated, fibrous or the radiating structure. So the foliated structure is similar to lamellar in broader sense, but in this case the individual seeds are paper thin, they are thin like the paper seeds, even thinner and can be easily separated in forms. Okay, so they are so thin that we can easily separate them. So the best example is the muscovite mica. If you would have seen muscovite mica in the field, you would have seen that there are some layers, very thin layers, just like the sheets of paper. So you can just separate it out. Okay, you can separate it out from one another sheets. So that's the property of muscovite. So the correct option here is option B, foliated form. Next one is identify the type of structure. So lamellar, foliated, radiating, or the granular. So the mineral is made up of the needle-like or the fibrous crystals, which appears originating from a common point, thereby giving a radiating appearance, as if it is said to be radiating in nature. Okay, and the best example of this mineral, that is the iron pyrite or FeS2. Okay, so the correct option here is radiating, option C. Ninth one is chromite shows which type of structure. Which type of structure is shown by the chromite? Granular, globular, rainy form, or the mammillary form? So chromite, so mineral which occur as the aggregates of the equidimensional grains, means these are made up of the aggregates of the equidimensional, means the grains are equal in the dimension grains. For example, the best example is of the chromite. So the mineral occurs in the form of densely packed mass of the small grain like crystals, in the case of globular structure. And the best example is in the question given here, that is chromite. Okay, so the correct option here is option A, granular form. Next one is which form resembles a human kidney? Globular, rainy form, granular, or the mammillary form? So rainy form is similar to the globular, but the shape of the bulbs or the projection, they resembles to human kidney. Okay, and the example is, best example here is, that is hematite. Okay, so the correct option here is option B, rainy form. 11th one is malachite shows which type of structure? Rainy form, globular, mammillary, or the granular form? So mammillary is similar to globular in the structure, as we have discussed in the previous slide, but the projection are, they are conspicuous in size, overlapping in the arrangement, and rounded in shape. Okay, so this is how we can differentiate between mammillary and the globular structure. As in the previous slide we have seen, that is rainy form, that is also looks like globular structure, and the mammillary form, that is also similar to the globular structure, but the difference is in the projection. So projections are conspicuous in size, overlapping in the arrangement of the crystals or the minerals, and the rounded shape. And the best example of this form, that is the malachite. Okay, so the correct option here is option C, mammillary form. And the last question of today's discussion is, the SI unit, or the international unit, unit of specific gravity is ohm, gram per cubic centimeter, N upon cubic centimeter, or no unit. So we all know that is specific gravity is the ratio. Okay, so ratios between the density of a mineral and that of the water at the 4 degree Celsius, means the density of a mineral and the equal amount of water at 4 degree Celsius. So the ratio between these two, that is known as specific gravity. So since this is a ratio, that's why it has no unit. Okay, And if we talk about the specific gravity of common silicate minerals, that is about 2.65, and those of the ore minerals, that varies from 4.5 to 10 sometimes. So the silicate minerals, they are less, their specific gravity is less as compared to the ore minerals. In ore minerals, the density that ranges from 4.5 to 10. Okay, so that's a huge specific gravity. A rough estimate about the specific gravity of a mineral can be made by hefting method, or taking them in our hand, and we can just, by the method of hefting, means just predicting the specific gravity. Okay, so that's not the precise specific gravity, but by the process of hefting in hand, we can identify, we can predict the average specific gravity of a particular mineral. Okay, so the correct option here is no unit, option D. So this was our discussion about some other very important questions related to the physical properties of minerals, and in the next video, or in the coming video, we will talk some other related properties of the minerals. Okay, thank you.